Good afternoon, YouTube. So I'm in the back of the 4Runner today. This is the connector that the rear window relay module plugs into. So to get to that, you've got to take off this driver side back panel. So there's a bunch of clips. My panel's all broken up. I may be replacing this. I think this is the first time I've had it off in probably 20 years, and looks like it's gotten wet and it's gotten broken a few places, and a lot of the little push pin things are broken out. So yeah, maybe make myself a new panel. That's the way it's been going with the 4Runner build, is every time I get in to do something, I find like something else to get taken care of. So this is the rear window relay module that plugs in right there. It just hooks on with a couple of screws in there. What you can do is pop off this cover. And be careful with it, as you got 40-year-old plastic here you're dealing with. And then the circuit board just pulls right out. I went to the factory service manual, got the pin numbers, and then the wire colors. So 1 through 6 pins are on this side, and then 7 through 13 are on the back side. Yeah, so there's the relay module. You've got basically 4 little mini 12-volt relays, a bunch of diodes and resistors there. I'll put a link to my rear window webpage in the video description. It has all the schematics and everything. Anyway, the purpose of this video is just to show you a little modification I did to this relay board, oh, probably a good 25 years ago. And this is the first time I've been in here since I did that. You can see there I also marked the pin numbers on the circuit board here. And what I did was took 12 and 5 and just soldered a little piece of wire between them. And then 4 and 11, I soldered a piece of wire between those two. 11 and 12 might be for the rear door key switch that's outside. And then 4 and 5, I think, are the front switch up in the dash or in the center console, wherever your switch is located. So those two switches both roll the window up and down. The difference is the key switch in back works all the time. You plug the key into the switch, you turn it one way, the window goes up. You turn it the other way, the window goes down. The switch in the dash, you have to have the key in the ignition, and then the dash switch works. Well, I decided that was kind of a hassle, that I would like to have the dash switch work all the time. So if you just jumper those two solder pads together, or those 4, that pair and that pair, it basically makes the front switch work just like the key switch. So a couple of things to be wary of. If you do that, that switch in the dash, like I say, works all the time. You don't need a key. Your vehicle security is maybe a little bit less, although, you know, I have a soft top. So, I mean, that's just canvas and clear vinyl. There's a zipper at the top. You can unzip it, or you can get in with a, you know, a pocket knife. That's a security issue. The other thing would be if you have like little kids that like to get in your vehicle and pretend to drive and hit the buttons and switches, they can be rolling windows up and down and whatnot. So you need to think about doing that. The nice thing is it's easy to reverse. I could just take a wire cutter and cut those two little jumpers, and it would go back to normal. That's not a permanent modification. The third thing that I've never checked is you might cause a problem if you had somebody go to the back of the truck with the key and turn the window down, and somebody was in the front of the truck and hit the button to go up. Might cause a problem because you're trying to go up and down. You know, I've never run into that problem in 20 plus years. You know, the whole idea of having the switch and the dash work all the time is I can just use that switch. I don't have to dig out my key and try to fool around with the switch in the back. So yeah, I just wanted to show you that. When I did this modification, I didn't have a digital camera, so I never took a picture of it. But anyway, I'll be posting a picture on the web page, and then there's this video as well. So that's a handy little modification if you have a vehicle that it makes sense in. like I say, think about it, and if that applies to you, it's really handy. I really like being able to not have to grab the keys to pull the window up. Like if I'm out camping and drove into camp in the afternoon and you're setting things up and all of a sudden it starts raining and you, I left the windows open. I can just run in the truck and roll the windows up. Just like I had manual hand cranks, I can just hit the switch and the window goes up. I give it a thumbs up. I think it was one of the best things I ever did, that and then the power window. So I have power windows work all the time and the rear window works all the time. So I like that modification, but yeah, you may or may not. It's up to you.
Okay, there's the key. So I don't have that in the ignition, but here's my rear window switch. So you can probably hear the window in back going up and down. In case you're wondering, this is for my dual battery solenoid. It's actually a three position switch. In that position, it's set up so that ignition power turns on the solenoid that connects my two batteries together in parallel. And in the middle position, the solenoid is always off. It never turns on. And then if you listen here, there's a click, and what that does, that's my jump start position. And in the jump start position, the auxiliary battery supplies power to the solenoid, and that ties the two batteries together. So if my main battery goes dead, then I can use the auxiliary battery to turn on the solenoid, and then that basically jump starts the truck off of the second battery. This has worked really well. I've had that in the truck for probably 25 years and it just works. It's a built-in jump start capability.